Olha só, estamos aqui com o pessoal do Punho de Ferro, o Finn Jones e também o Tom Pelfrey, que faz o Ward Mitchum, e o Danny Rand, você sabe, você conhece Marvel, você conhece Netflix. Guys, thank you very much for being here. It's a pleasure to have you here. We love Marvel Comics, we love the TV series, and it's a great pleasure.
Thank you, it's great to be here. We've been in Brazil for a couple of hours now, and so far it's been really nice, huh?
Yeah. Obrigado. Yeah. Thank you for having you.
Hey, so I've got a question before we start.
Sure.
Why omelet? Why is it called omelet? Are you guys just like super into eggs?
Actually, it's kind of a mixture of a lot of things. TV comics.
Oh, and movies. I see. So you like crack the omelet and then you throw everything inside.
You can choose whatever you want.
Oh. Yeah.
What do you know about Recife? Did anybody tell you about?
I actually didn't know that much. I've got a friend back home who's from Paraguay, and I was telling her about Recife, and she was like, "No way, you're going to Recife?" I was like, "Yeah." She was like, "That place is so beautiful." And she gave me loads of like tips and places to go. So
I've seen the series, and I believe that dynamic that you guys have on screen is like the two roles is one of the best things that Marvel ever did on screen.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, because you're the believer and you're the skeptic. How did you guys work out this kind of dynamic on screen?
It is a nice juxtaposition because you know, Danny is so kind of sweet and naive and innocent, and I think in some ways looking up to Ward a little bit, almost like a big brother, you know. And then Ward is, I think he loves Danny, but I think Danny's presence is causing him problems. So his anger and his frustration with Danny is kind of less about Danny's personality, in my opinion, and more about the fact that you're here is screwing things up, you know, which is a nice dynamic. It's always nice, I think. I have a younger brother. I always think it's nice to play any kind of dynamic that feels like siblings, whether it's Ward and Joy or Ward and Danny and Joy, because there's a way that siblings can fight and hate each other and love each other all at the same time. Mm-hmm. And that, I think, is specific to brothers and sisters, you know?
And I think it was also nice that there's a lot of backstory between the two characters. They grew up together. There was an element of bullying there as well. So even from the beginning of the show, we knew the history of the characters.
Yeah.
So when we came to play, there was already those layers already there that we could kind of tap back into, which was kind of cool.
How do you play this role in the way that people may actually believe that you're naive?
Yeah, for me, it was just about being open to be as vulnerable as possible. Vulnerable in strength and naivety and optimism. I don't think you see a lot of superheroes these days that kind of wear their heart on their sleeve in such an open manner. And I just tried to kind of interpret the work and come to the work with an openness. And Danny's flaws, I didn't try and hide or cover up. I embraced them and I just let them kind of be displayed. So really kind of just an openness, I guess.
Of course, you have read some comics of Iron Fist before you did. Do you have a favorite story?
I like the Immortal Iron Fist. That's a really great one. I also like the Living Weapon. And I'm reading the new one at the moment.
It's dark.
Really visceral, yeah. It reminds me of the Immortal Iron Fist, the other one. But I've got a huge stack of them at the end of my bed. So every time I go to sleep, I just kind of get one out and just like start flicking through it. So.
Can you believe this nerd?
Are we on Defenders?
I can't comment. No comment.
Okay,
yeah,
right.
Sorry.
That's cool.
But we know he is for sure, obviously.
Oh, really?
What people can expect from the Defenders?
It takes place over a very short amount of time. I think it takes place maybe over like 3 or 4 days.
Wow.
So it's, yeah, so the energy to the show is very frenetic and it's very like go, 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 go. So we're kind of thrust together in a very chaotic way and we just kind of have to make do with the situation we're put under. So it's very kind of intense, but also there's a lot of fun in it as well. Between the four of us, there's a lot of really interesting dynamics. A lot of like kind of friendships, allies are formed, but there's also a lot of tension between us as well.
In Marvel Comics, there's a great dynamic between Luke Cage and Danny Rand. Is that something that people can expect?
Yeah, there's lots of that. And it's been really great working with Mike. Like me and Mike have a great natural rapport as actors and as friends on set. And then also the characters themselves, they come from very different backgrounds. And when they meet, they learn something from each other.
We have a writer here in Brazil, that's Paulo Coelho.
Do you know him? Oh, I had the book in my back pocket and now
he's
not
literally
here.
Had the book in his back pocket all day.
Wow. I've just read The Alchemist. I fucking love that book so much.
That's the most famous one.
Yeah. I'm reading The Warrior of the Light at the moment and then you were telling me about...
Yeah, I love Paulo Coelho. So I was telling him to read Veronica Decides to Die.
Guys, thank you very much for being here. It's a pleasure.
Thanks so much for having us. Thank you. Obrigado.